now I am interested about working of spring MVC. MVC is known as model, V is for view and C is for control. Here all the operations spring will be done by using this spring MVC one. Here the client is known as our site, that is maybe some applications or some browsers, that is Google Chrome, Microsoft and some others, all come under client side. Here the browser will send the request to the server, that is same as the servlets. Here it will reach the springs dispatcher servlet will play a major role, and when the request is raised to the dispatcher servlet, we send the data to the mapper will get that particular URL and send the response to the servlet. Again it will send the data to the controller, and then controller to model is a business logic. Here all the operations will be done in the business logic, whether it is get or post some other operations, and all are come under models, and then model will give the response to the controller, and then controller to the dispatcher server. Here the dispatcher server is send the data to the view resolver. This it is used for the controlling of sending or returning the returning, and it will return the logical name of view. It will be sent to the logical name of the view. Here the view resolver it can be done by adding the suffix under the add JSP and returns to the dispatch server. And then again the request the dispatch server will send the data, the whole data to the .jsp files and .jsp .xml to the view. Here the view will play as input output role. Here the view is used to get the data and send the data. So view will send the request to the browser. It will be shown to the browser in our screens. And coming to advantages of screens, we have some few advantages. One is we can create application by using Spring framework. We all know that Spring is a framework, and it can be ready to use. We need to just know that where it is used, and where we can insert that logics. Here, we can also create applications as well as in servlets. In servlet also, we create some app web apps. Here it is easy than the servlets, and here creating dependency injection and being passed by using Spring Core. Here dependencies can be created and can be under the bean classes also created by using Spring Core, and we can also create singleton classes. Singleton classes means we can only one class which is known as singleton classes, and we can write object automatically. Here the object will be creation can be created by using the strings. And coming to base for sending data from browser to server, we use 5 methods. One is form data, and query string, cookie, path parameter method, and the last one is matrix parameter method. And all this comes under base for sending the data from browser to server. Thank you.